You know, 22 years ago, this device was released by Sony. It's a PSP or PlayStation Portable. I'm curious how many of you had this device, how many of you recognize this device, and please write a comment and share with us this info. So this is the PlayStation, PlayStation Portable from 2004 from Sony. It was such an extreme device at that moment, and even now in the present, it seems almost impossible to have this technology here to read this, because the games, they weren't on a micro SD card, they were on these small DVDs or CDs, whatever you want to call it. They are named UMD, Universal Media Disc. Look, this is it. And you put this inside of your console here, like this, and you play it. So this is the console. It was such an impressive device then, and still is even now. It has so much to offer. It has such beautiful games even now. By the way, this screen, it's an LCD 4.3 inches, and look, you have the buttons here, everything at your command. You have the main menu here. Now we are in the main menu. When you enter the game, you press this, you have the volume, you have even a microphone here, the logo, you have the light and the sound, you have select start, you have the on off button or pause button, because if you do something like this, it will enter in standby mode. You can wake this device by pressing again this button, sliding it like this. You have left, right, you have a Wi-Fi for multiplayer games. At that moment in 2004, I remember it was such an impressive aspect to play in multiplayer, for example, Mortal Kombat with another friend. So if your friend had something like this, you just hit this WLAN button, and you would create a local multiplayer session for your games. Here you can put a micro SD card, a proprietary card like this. This is it. This is how it looks. And you know, let's start the game and let's see it in action. So, as I said, after 22 years, it's hard to believe that this console, it looks like this and it feels in this way. The next generation after this one was this. It's the PlayStation Vita with an OLED display here, a bigger screen, a touch screen. You have a touch panel on the back here, a multi-touch panel, the entire area here, and many other features. Anyway, this console, it's a beast also, and such a beauty. So the next generation was this one, but and it seems that I have to put inside the micro SD card, but it will start without saving. This is good. This is good. So you can still find games like these ones, and they are very, very cheap, very cheap. And you can play with them here on PlayStation, on your PSP. So this is it. Let's start the game and let's see how it looks. Anyway, this LCD display, it's great, and it will manage to deliver a very good experience for you here. Look how nice it looks. Definitely it's not an OLED, but still, for 22 years, I'd say this is impressive. This sound, it's this UMD here, it's spinning at high speeds, you know, like a DVD, something like this. And in the game you will hear it very slow, and sometimes because the console will read the game now, will start it, will buffer it or whatever it's doing over there, and it will move it sometimes when you progress in the game. But what you hear is now in the beginning, and after that it will calm down. Let's call it in this way. So look how nice it looks. In my opinion, if you are asking, even now in 2022, this console, it's magnificent. And if you want to experience some classics, some classic games, it's definitely it's worth it. And if you don't want to play on this, if you want a bigger screen or something like this, you can go with PlayStation Vita. It's another level and another experience, definitely better and improved. Go for the fat model 1000, because there are two models, 1000 and 2000. Only this has the OLED display, that impressive OLED. The other one, the model 2000, has an LCD. So this is Grand Theft Auto here on portable PlayStation, the first generation here. This is not the first model, it's a model 3000. So you will find various models. For example, you will have model PSP 1000, model PSP 2000, 3000, and also a sliding device, PSP Go. It's called PSP N1000, and another E1000 or PSP Street. Anyway, this is the model PSP 3000, a very good device, and let's see how we start here. You know, for a device with 22 years on the back, in the back, 22 years, you know. It's impressive what it does, and what can I say, it has a better drawing distance than Grand Theft Auto from Nintendo Switch nowadays. What can I say, this is it. And it has a better frame rate, well, indeed. And so this is the console, and if you are asking me, definitely you should try something like this in 2022. It's a classic device that still has a lot to offer. They have a different technology here for the joystick. It feels different, but it's great to use it. It doesn't have two joysticks. This was the design at that moment, but still you won't need another joystick in games. I believe there are a few games where you will feel the need of a joystick, but this is it. You will manage, and the games are well optimized. The sound is stereo, very very loud and nice, and as I said, you have a microphone here on the console. This is it, a beautiful device even now. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to share with us your experience, if you have this device or not, if you still play this or not, and what is your opinion related to it. So in this way you can stop a game without using your software here. And this is the main menu of the console. You can use it for videos, music, you can put pictures on it, you can even put a camera here. It was such a great device for that time. And this is it. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe.